Hello dear colleague, I, Mrs. Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in 1 week FDP on e-content development and effective use of ICT. This online FDP is organized by Modern College of Engineering. In this session, I am explaining you how to assign grade category for different assignments in your classwork. This you are going to do in a Google Classroom when you are going to play the role of teacher. The student can't do all these things. So now let's move to your Google account or the classroom where you are playing the role of teacher. Now here, I have already explained in my previous session how to create the material, how to reuse the post, how to use the topic to separate all the contents or the material of your study material or the things which you are going to provide to the student. And now we are looking for the assignments. In these assignments, I have already explained you how to create the assignment and how to assign the grades. Now in this session, in this current session, I am explaining you how to assign the grade category and what is grade category and how it is useful. For this, we need to create a new assignment. You can update the things with the already provided assignment if you are having these many assignments with you. And for these assignments, if you want to add a category, that also you can do. Before assigning the categories, we need to go to the settings, because settings will help us to create the category. So what we will do, after clicking on this settings, you just scroll down and here in the grading section, what we have to do. First of all, we need to select grade categories. Here you can see that grade categories are there and here you can add the category. What do you mean by this grade category? Why are we supposed to give, or why are we supposed to assign, or why are we supposed to create all these different grade categories? Now suppose if you are going to divide the whatever the marks students are obtaining, if you want to divide them into different categories, for example their term work or the practical assignments, you supposed to give the mark to their practical assignments, whatever they are doing for that, and a few of the marks you want to assign as the internal assessment. Suppose from the 100%, you are giving the 60% marks to your lab assignments and 40% marks to your internal assessment to give the term work to the students. In this case, you can divide your assignments in these different categories. So I am giving the first category as lab assignment. After giving the name to this grade category, it asks that how many points you want to give. So as I explained previously, I want to give the 60% for this first category. Now after this, what we supposed to do? After doing this, we need to add the another category. I will click on add grade category, and now I will give the thing like internal assessment. That is all the tests for all the units you are going to take for the students. All that marks you can assign as the internal assignment, and that I want to give it as a remaining 40%. Here you need to choose it as a weighted by category, means this will get reflected in the classwork section whenever you are going to assign the category. Now if I am going, I am very sorry, you need to select this weighted by category first, and then here you can give the percentage. So first, from the 100%, I will choose the 60% over here. So it will show you the remaining are 40%. How to divide this remaining 40%? That suppose I am giving this 40% to my internal assessment. If you are supposed to give this only the 30% you can give it, and again it will show you that the 10% are remaining. Suppose if you want to give the 10% more 10% for case studies, you can give it. So I want to explain you that you can decide different categories in which you can grade the students, and accordingly you can create the grade categories over here. So in this way you can assign the categories. And now after that, the more setting is about grading is show overall grade to students. If you will keep it on, then the overall grade of the student will send to the students login. If you don't want to show it, keep it off. Now you have to save all these settings, whatever changes you have done, you have to save it. Now we will see what the changes are there in the create assignment section. Now let's start for the creation of the assignment. Now here you can see that let's wait for a while. I need to explain you one more thing, that previously whatever the assignments are done by us, they are not graded in the category. But now let's see the change, how it will look like. So now just create an assignment. After creation of the assignment, my first step is give the title, that is I am giving lab assignment 1. Whatever the assignment is you want to give, that you can type over here whatever the assignment is, or if your students are having only already the syllabus, then no need to give. It is dependent on you what you are going to give the title. If any instructions you want to give, you can give the instructions. If you want to upload any file for this, you can upload it or you can create it. I have already explained you for which class. Here a single class is there, that's why it is disabled. For the students, suppose for VE, the elective subjects are there. For that elective subjects, suppose few of the students has opted a different subject, and few of the students has opted my subject, for example. So what I will do, I will go to this all students section. I will select only the students which have opted my elective subjects, and to that student only I am going to assign this particular assignment. For this purpose, you can do, or you can select the particular student. Now here in this grade category, we need to select it the drop down list, and I will select this lab assignment. So it will get graded under this assignment. Whatever now I am going to create is get graded under the category lab assignments. Now you have to select the grade points. For this I am going to select it as 10, and if you want to select the due date, otherwise you can select it, otherwise no need to give the due date. If you don't want to give, then it's not mandatory. If you want to select it under or assign it under any particular topic, so different topics are here which already created. If you want to create a new topic, this also the facility given by Google at this point also. So in this way you can do this. What the rubric is, so the rubric a rubric is nothing but here you can create a rubric, or you can reuse a rubric, or import it from different sheets. I will explain you rubric in separate video. Now here I am clicking on this assign. Here also the same thing I have already explained, assign schedule or save as draft, or you can discard the draft. So I am assigning it. After assigning, you can see, yes, you can see over here, this is the graded assignment, that's why it is highlighted over here. This is graded under lab assignments. And now the same thing will appear in the students login, that is students must have received the mail from the teacher or from the classroom that this new assignment is posted. We will wait till this mail is received by the student, or I already explained you how the mail is received by the student. There is nothing different for this particular assignment. Now in this way we can assign the grade category to the assignment. Suppose you want to create one more assignment for the internal assessment. For that, suppose this is my test 1. So if I'm giving this first test to the students, that you can create as the quiz from the forms. So how to work on forms and how to create the quiz, that I'm going to explain you in separate session. So for that, you just stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. Now currently, suppose I'm giving the list of the question, and for that I can add an attachment, or I can give the all the questions over here by 1, 2, 3 and so on. This also you can do, or you can attach an attachment as well. So this will help you to create the test. Now for this test, suppose I am giving again, here you need to first of all select the category, that is internal assessment, and now here I am suppose giving the marks, that is 30 to for this particular test I can give. Due date, yes, I can assign the due date, I can start the test, and I can assign the due date where you can select the date and time over here, that you can do. Now after this, I will assign this particular assignment to the students. Here you can see that this is the assignment under internal assessment. So in this way, you can do the categories, and you can use these categories for your internal assessment. How it is useful? So that I will explain you when I will explain you the grades part from these different tabs. Currently, we have just seen how to add the category, how it is useful, and how if you want to remove it or if you want to update it, you just go back to the settings and you can go over here. Suppose now if I don't want these case studies, what I will do, I will delete it. So after deletion, it will show you again the 10% are remaining where you want to add it. Suppose I will give 40% to the internal assessment, then there is no any remaining thing, and after that only this save button is enabled. So after saving, now here you can see that for the creation of any of the assignment, you can see that the category are two, only two categories are available, that is lab assignment and internal assessment. So in this way you can update the categories as well. So thank you dear colleagues for listening and watching my video. If you are having any query, please post your query in the comment box. I will try to solve all your queries. For your reference, I am providing you the shortcut for the next video of this classroom series, and for your reference, I am providing a playlist for this G Suite or the Google Suite. Thank you.